Nice seeing you again. Now that we have a common understanding of what a management information system is, and hopefully we agree that understanding them better might be a good use of our time, let us discuss one of the key decisions companies must take regarding their management information systems: make versus buy. You can see in the video the clothes I am wearing. With the current technology, I am unable to divine what you are wearing, but I assume you also have some clothes on you. May I ask, how did you get those clothes? Did you go to a shop and buy them ready-made? Or have they been tailor-made, custom-made? If they were tailor-made, did you sew them yourselves? Or did you have a seamster or a dressmaker sew them for you? And if they were ready-made, did you nevertheless make some adjustments or tailoring? And if so, did you carry out the tailoring yourself, or did you get someone else to do it for you? The answer to these questions is likely to significantly affect the way you dress. We can now draw an analogy with the make versus buy decision and certain related outsourcing decisions companies must take regarding their management information systems. In this video, we shall discuss the ready-made versus custom-made choice, and in the next, we shall explore the option of subcontracting and its implications. Thus, companies must decide whether the management information systems that will be the nervous system of their organization will be acquired off the shelf, packaged from software vendors, or will involve bespoke applications developed ad hoc for the specific requirements. They may also decide to use standard pre-existing off-the-shelf packages for some systems and custom-made bespoke developments for others. This is a key strategic decision, which should be clearly differentiated from the more tactical decision of who will build the system if a bespoke development is chosen. Ad hoc bespoke management information systems development allows companies to build systems that precisely fit the requirements specified by its management and business users. When, in the past, I have presented managers with this choice, the bespoke development often has an intuitive appeal. For the company's information systems professional, bespoke development offers other advantages, such as technological challenges, more responsibilities, and perhaps enhanced job security, since becoming the experts in critical systems makes them valuable for their employer. On the other hand, off-the-shelf, pre-written packaged software is developed by software houses and sold to and installed by many different user companies. They strive to offer the functionalities most companies will demand. Depending on their sophistication, they might offer some limited parameterization or customization options, as we shall discuss later in this course, to improve the fit with the user company's business requirements. Ready-made packages have four main advantages over bespoke development: cost, time, maintenance, and know-how best practices. First, cost. The cost of a ready-made package is spread over its multiple users. Thus, the cost of the license is generally only a fraction of that of a bespoke development. Second, time. Since it already exists, implementation times and risks are generally much lower. Third, maintenance. Tried and tested software is likely to have less bugs and technical problems than a newly developed ad hoc application. Besides, the user company can sign a maintenance contract with the software provider encompassing bug fixes, support, and access to new versions or enhancements to keep the application up to date. Four, as for know-how and best practices, it is indeed true that a pre-written package may impose a way of doing business that differs from the current practice in the user company. This annoyance, however, might sometimes actually be a bonus, since packages are normally developed to support the generally accepted best practices. Packages often incorporate implicit know-how on the way of conducting business that is generally deemed to be most appropriate, and thus can lead to improved operation. Over time, the advantages of pre-written packages have led to a gradual shift from bespoke developments to off-the-shelf packages. In many companies, old systems awaiting replacement, the so-called legacy systems, tend to be custom-made bespoke applications, while as the new systems that are gradually replacing them are generally packages. Increasingly, bespoke development is reserved for those areas of the business that confer a differentiation-based competitive advantage. That is, that lead to a competitive edge based precisely on carrying out certain business activities in a different and original way, and thus cannot be properly supported by standard packaged applications. Bespoke development is also needed to properly integrate disparate applications, as well as to cater for some very specific or unique requirements for which appropriate pre-existing packages may not exist. As for the eventual adaptation required by ready-made packages, we will postpone its analysis until later on in this course. In the next video, we shall discuss a related decision, namely whether to use internal company resources to tackle whichever bespoke development is carried out, or rather subcontract or outsource that to external providers. I will see you there. Thanks for watching.